Good morning, dear students. Myself Ms. Deepthi from Dips Karol Bagh. In today's lecture, we are continuing the reading of History Chapter 2, Establishment of Company Power. And in today's lecture, we are going to read about the Carnatic Wars. These Carnatic Wars were very important, plays a very important role in Indian history, as these wars established East India Company as a powerful company in the India. So let's start. This war was fought between the French East India French and British to control over the coastal strips. These were wars called Carnatic Wars, as most of the battles were fought in the Carnatic and other parts of Tamil Nadu. These were fought between 1744 and 1763. The French were led by the Dupleix, who retitled by the occupying Madras in 1746. Madras was under the control of Alauddin, the Nawab of Carnatic. The British appealed to Anwaruddin, and he sent an army to fight against the French. The Indian army was defeated by the well-trained French army. In 1748, the war became an end, and Madras was restored to the British. The war was again fought between the British and the French over the succession of the throne of Hyderabad and the Carnatic. The French supported Muzaffar Jung, and the British gave support to Nasir Jung and at Hyderabad. In the Carnatic, the French supported Chand Sahib, and the British gave support to the Muhammad Ali. However, the French were defeated, and a treaty was signed according to which Dupleix were called back to France. In 1756, the French French forces led by the Count de Lally was defeated, and a peace treaty was signed in 1763. The French factories were returned to them, but on the condition that they will fortify the same, and all factories were made to serve as the trade centers only. French lost their strength, which gave the British a lead position on the political scenes of India. So here they have told us the different Carnatic wars fought on Indian ground, and why these wars are known as Carnatic War, because all these wars were fought on the in Carnatic, Carnatic and nearby the parts of Tamil Nadu itself. So ultimately, these wars made the British a successor in the East India. British power. The British received permissions from Mughal Emperor Jahangir to carry on in trade. Thomas Roy visited India and obtained the right to trade and established factories in India. As a result, factories were established at Surat, Ahmedabad and Baroch. In 1639, the Fort St. George was built in Madras. In 1668, King Charles II of England got the city of Bombay as a dowry when he married the Portuguese princess Henrietta of Braganza. In 1781, the British built the Fort William in Calcutta. In 1717, the Mughal Emperor Farrukh Shah granted the British the right to trade in Bengal and Bihar on the payment of 3,000 per annum. So these were the British power. In this paragraph we have read about the how the British power come to an exist in India and how they have made their factories in different part of India. Next is the extension of British power. In 1696 the British received from the Sabrana Roy Chaudhary three villages, namely Shushanut, Govindpur and Kalika, which later developed into the city of Calcutta. The British constructed from Fort William to safeguard their settlements. The British started expanding their settlements. The Nawab of Bengal, Siraju Dola, made them to leave the Calcutta, but Lord Clive made an alliance with the Mir Jafar, the commander-in-chief of the Nawab's army, and Jagat Seth, a banker. With their help, Siraju Dola was defeated and killed in the Battle of Plassey in 1757. This battle paved the way for the British to eventually conquer the whole India. Mir Jafar, who was appointed as a Nawab, gave the permission to the British to collect revenue from 24 Pargana and gave them the right to trade without taxes. The reason of defeat of Siraju Dola were: number one, British superior in all aspects. Number two, Nawab was inexperienced. Number three, Nawab was betrayed by his officials. Number four, Nawab did not take the help from the French. So, these paragraphs tell us that how the British power come to an exist. So Siraju Dola से इन्होंने बंगाल से इन्होंने सारा काम शुरू किया. बंगाल में इनकी फर्स्ट टेरिटरी बनी थी और फर्स्ट फोर्टिफाई करना शुरू किया था. एंड बंगाल से ही जब बंगाल को इन्होंने बंगाल के नवाब Siraju Dola को इन्होंने बैटल ऑफ प्लासी में 1757 में हराया और उसके बाद में इन्होंने दीवानी मिल गई थी बंगाल की उड़ीसा की और बिहार की. तो यहाँ से ये लोग इन्हों की प्रोग्रेस शुरू हुई एंड दे हैव स्टार्टेड देयर एडमिनिस्ट्रेटिव वर्क इन इंडिया. इन नेक्स्ट लेक्चर वी आर गोइंग टू रीड अबाउट द बैटल ऑफ बक्सर एंड द रिजल्ट ऑफ बैटल ऑफ बक्सर. थैंक यू वेरी मच. हैव ए नाइस डे. स्टे होम, स्टे हेल्दी.